Jerusalem, its name means City of Peace. Yet it's been destroyed, rebuilt, conquered, and reconquered more times than any other city in history.
The city has a role to play. It's the center of the world.
For 19 years, Jerusalem was divided between Israel and Jordan, with the old city on the Jordan side. In 1967, the Six-Day War led to the reuniting of the city under Israeli sovereignty. Now, part of the U.S.-backed peace process seeks to split the city once again. But Israel maintains Jerusalem is its eternal, undivided capital. Palestinians want the eastern part for the capital of a future state. But Jerusalem Mayor Nir Barkat told me dividing the city is impossible.
It cannot be divided. It will never function as a divided city. It has to be one physical city, enabling all to worship their faith their way, to respect each other, and there's room for all.
Can you convince Palestinians of that?
The Palestinian residents that live in Jerusalem understand that.
Yeah.
And, you know, I'm also a high-tech entrepreneur, a venture capitalist.
Yes.
It will never work. There's not one good example of a city that was split that ever functioned.
Jerusalem is mentioned by name more than 800 times in the Bible, even more if you count synonyms like the City of David and Zion. 660 of those references are in the Hebrew Bible or Old Testament.
I remember this very day. I sat in the park, my kids were playing in the park, and I realized when Zechariah said there will yet be a time when old men and old women rest on the canes and children will play in the streets of Jerusalem, maybe my kids are what he saw.
I sat down with author and businessman Moishe Kempinski and asked him about the Jewish connection to this city.
What does Jerusalem mean to the Jewish people? I mean, it's like an inane question, but, you know, why Jerusalem?
Well, it's a name because it could be a name because why Jerusalem? Why not a city next to resources on the shores, which is where most people put their capital cities? But God chose it.
The city being divided at one point, reunited again in 67, will it be divided again?
I don't think it can be. Psalm 122 says, to Jerusalem that is built as a city that is compacted together. But in Hebrew, it doesn't say compacted. In Hebrew, it actually says, shechubra la'yachdav, that's reunited together. God is saying, this is a city that will be torn asunder, but then I'm going to bring it back together.
I talked with Israelis in Tel Aviv. They say they're willing to share the city, but not divide it.
My heart, it's something that I cannot agree with.
Right.
You know, that my town is going to be separated.
We believe that Jerusalem is supposed to be Jewish forever, but I do believe that there is supposed to be a solution that's going to be good for the both of the people.
Kempinski says God has a plan for the city, whether the world believes in it or not.
What do other nations say when you, or other groups say, when you speak the way you're speaking now, with your argument, your point of view? How does a Palestinian respond to that?
The secret, I think the secret to understanding this country is that facts are completely irrelevant.
Facts
are completely irrelevant. Reality is not what counts here. Perception of reality is what counts. And I believe that to understand what goes on here, especially with the Palestinians, is you need to understand what they perceive. They really believe what they believe because they've been told that's what they need to believe. So dialogue with a Palestinian today has become almost impossible because Islam has moved into an area where it's become impossible.
Jerusalem is never mentioned by name in the Quran, but Muslims interpret a reference to the furthest mosque being Al-Aqsa Mosque on Jerusalem's Temple Mount. Muslims and Arab Christians are passionate about their connection to the city.
This is all Arab town. This is Arab town, can't be divided.
They even argue among themselves.
I didn't say to give.
You can't divide
Never
the whole city.
I say to give.
Jerusalem, I said, is fully for Palestinians.
And it's
not Israeli. Israel outside
the
occupied
the
territory. Where is Zion Gate?
What you are going to do
so
with the Wailing Wall?
So here's the issue, right?
The Wailing Wall, they could have the Wailing Wall and the Armenian Quarter.
As one of the most contested places on earth, the Bible says Jerusalem will be a stumbling block to the entire world.
We pray for the peace of Jerusalem. What are we praying for?
The word for peace is
Shalom.
Shalom. It comes out of the word shalem, complete.
Right.
We're praying for that completion, when the heavenly and the earthly will be clearly seen as being united. It's not a future event, it's a future revelation.
You think it's going to happen in your lifetime?
I believe it's imminent.